All right, well, we'll start with probably the one of the most interesting fights recently. It says, tell us about the Twitter fight with V. So no Twitter fight with V yet. But basically what happened was that we had a thread about Ouroboros. Vitalik posted some questions and concerns about Ouroboros. I answered. Vitalik answered back. And then I realized that Reddit probably wasn't the best of mediums. So I had a discussion with the scientists behind Ouroboros, and I said, could we write a formal rebuttal? And basically what we did was we sat down and tried to find as much information as we could about Casper, which was extremely difficult because there's lots of different papers. There's Vlad's Casper, there's Vitalik's Casper, there's like two or three white papers, there's some FAQs. Apparently there were some repos that formalized some stuff, but they've been pulled. And we made best effort to try to understand as much as we could about Casper. And we tried to do a fair comparison. But unfortunately, Casper is not written in a way that makes it particularly easy for an academic comparison between it and our protocol. So we did our best. We posted the rebuttal. Vitalik's response was to say it was pathetic, call us liars, and then say that it was a some sort of hit piece. I guess he's not used to being challenged, and I guess he's not used to having an academic rebuttal. Makes sense, because he dropped out of first semester, and he never went through that process personally, but the rebuttal that we provided was what one would expect if they go through a standard peer review and they had submitted a paper or they asked a colleague to look at it. So anyway, we might write some more, we might not. It just depends on how we feel, but we think the things we said were perfectly reasonable and we're pretty proud of our protocol. Some things that Vitalik wrote were quite strange, like we're violating the FLP impossibility theorem. Not sure how, but I guess he asserts that and other such things. And, you know, it is what it is. And we're pretty happy with our strategy. All of the Ouroboros papers have been accepted at major conferences. People from all over the world, from China to Japan to all the European countries to the United States have looked at it. And we've gotten a lot of great feedback. Things like finality can be added. You know, we already have a probabilistic notion of it. And we're pretty happy with the protocol. Also, a huge amount of work has been done to verify the proofs of the protocol and that we have two different ways of proving the core claims of Ouroboros. Both have been published and gone through peer review. We also have formal verification of many of the proofs using Isabel, thanks to Conwin's work at Cambridge. So there's been about 3 years worth of work that we've put into the effort, and we've gotten tremendous feedback from people all over the world, and we're pretty happy about it. One little caveat, Vitalik said, well, we could have simply emailed him or had a conversation about Casper. What's extraordinary about that statement is, despite the fact that we've been publicly working on Ouroboros for over 3 years, and he never really reached out to us. We saw him at Financial Crypto. We saw him at the Bitcoin Winter School in Shanghai and other places. And despite the fact that we keep crossing paths, didn't really seem to care too much about asking our scientists in person about how does Ouroboros work or if there was any potential to collaborate between the teams. But now that we're having a public rebuttal, apparently we should keep it to email or something like that. Or our rebuttal is apparently a hit job. So that's that. Good for them. And we're just going to keep chipping away. We got some great things coming for Ouroboros to accelerate downloading the blockchain. We got some things to add some accelerated transactions, get better finality with them. We got some things coming to add sharding to it. And we're really excited about the future of the protocol, and the science really looks beautiful. And we're starting to get to those fine tuning pieces to make the protocol really awesome. And we're extremely excited about the formal verification side of things, where we can actually write a spec and prove some interesting properties out. Our formal methods team is just salivating at that opportunity. So overall, we're on track. Things are looking good. Science is looking good. And I look forward to seeing everybody at Crypto and at CCS and future conferences. Thanks for all the support.
If you enjoy this content, please subscribe to our YouTube channel and click the little bell beside the subscribe button to ensure you get notified of future important videos and live streams.